spell your first last name for us?
Matt Florell, MattFlorell.
Okay. You have been a very outspoken opponent of red light cameras for a long time. How excited are you about this proposed legislation?
Cautiously optimistic. There's a lot of money going around in Tallahassee lobbying. ATS, the largest vendor of red light cameras in Florida, has 22 full-time paid lobbyists whose job it is to keep their product legal in the state of Florida. So there's a lot of money and a lot of people and a lot of special interests, League of Cities included, that are very, very dedicated to keeping that revenue stream going. So it's an uphill battle, but the facts are on our side, and hopefully we'll be able to win this time. But some more modest goals. I know there are some other bills that are going to be filed that are going to go after cities, or at least try to hold cities accountable for short yellow times, and probably try to take right turn on red out of automated enforcement, because that has nothing to do with safety. So at least hopefully there will be some small victories this year if we can't get the big victory.
Why are you so passionate about it?
Because I've studied it, and the stats show that red light cameras really don't help with safety. Here in the city of St. Petersburg, we saw the red light camera intersections. Crashes went up 10%, rear ends went up 40%, angle crashes went up 30%. You know, if this was a safety program, we should see some safety improvements, but all we've seen is an improvement to the bottom line of the general fund.
That's one of the points that the senator makes as to why he wants right. to get rid of this. He thinks that the city is just padding their pockets.
Well, when you see what happens in communities like Collier County, where they raised their yellow times and they got rid of right turn on red, you see they didn't see any reason to keep it because there was no money being made, and they clearly saw that there was no safety impact. So, you know, if there is no safety impact, and they had cameras for 3 years, they just got rid of them this year because they didn't help anything.
It's an uphill battle, though, because money's being made, and there's all these lobbyists, like you said. Do you think that the bill has a chance in the form that it's in right now?
Just outlawing red light cameras, unfortunately, probably not. If it goes through the regular committee process, usually there's a committee that has more ATS-aligned legislators than non-ATS-aligned legislators, because they spend tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of dollars donating to statewide candidates and state office holders. So there's a lot of money being spent to try to keep influence over legislators to keep red light cameras legal in the state of Florida.
You also run stpetpolls.org. What has, you always ask the question about red light cameras, I'm pretty sure I've seen it on every single one. So. Is there any movement in people's opinion?
It's been going down slowly in the last year, but early on it was generally about 50-50. There were slightly more people that approved it than didn't, and it is a scientific survey. And generally it's older people that are in favor of red light cameras and younger people that are opposed to them. And that's what we've seen steadily maintain over the last 2 years that we've been polling on that. But attitudes have been changing, and it's down to only 40% approval as of last month's survey.
Anything I didn't ask you that you'd like to add?
I can't think of anything.
Did you have anything, Brian? Okay. Well, when you think about the argument of, you know, safety, and if people are just aware and they're cautious about the fact that a camera's there, do you hear that argument a lot?
I hear a lot of arguments, but it's difficult to say what influences you. I know that the rear end crashes going up is because people are overly cautious, and they're paranoid, and they're really worried. And the fact that the city has been caught using short yellow lights, and a lot of other cities, Tampa and, you know, Brooksville, Collier County, they've all been caught with short yellows, you know, that just adds to the paranoia. The city's out to get you, they're out to make money, and, you know, they're fixing the game, they're rigging the system to not give me enough time to stop, to not give me enough time to get through the intersection so they can make more money.
So, that study that you mentioned, which one is that? Is that the USF study?
Which study?
The one about the more accidents, an increase in accidents in St. Petersburg.
That's actually a spreadsheet I got from the city.
Oh, really?
And then I put the total tallies it, because they didn't have those, and it took a couple of information requests to get that information. And but once I finally had it, it was clear to see that crashes have gone up, and there really was no finagling of the numbers to make it seem like they didn't. Although they, you know, here's the confusing part. They broke it down into something called red light running crashes and red light related crashes. And if you didn't know what their definition for what red light related meant, then you might think that, oh, red light related crashes, that, you know, they went down, so that's a good thing. Well, the only difference between a red light running crash and a red light related crash is a running crash is the police ticketed somebody, and a red light related crash means that the police couldn't ticket anybody. And when you have cameras on an intersection, you know who ran the light and you know who to ticket. So it makes sense that the offenses where the police didn't know who to ticket would go down when you have cameras on an intersection. If we had regular cameras, video cameras, on these intersections, it would make red light related crashes go down with no ticketing involved. So, you know, it's they fixed the numbers, they fixed the definition, and gave it a vague term to make it seem like something that it really wasn't. You had to go to, I think, about page 80 or 90 in their report to find what the definition of a related crash was.
Do you still have the spreadsheet?
Oh yeah, it's up on the website. It's up on stpcameras.org. It's up on the city's website. So it's a big, full of errors. There are over 100 factual errors in the report, math errors, false statements, unsupported statements. It's a mess.
Well,
and I've told them all that, but you're
selective.